Welcome to a lesson on solving two-step equations with decimals. Let's review the steps on how to solve a basic two-step linear equation. Remember, the ultimate goal of solving a linear equation is to isolate the variable on one side of the equal sign. To do this, we'll first add or subtract in order to isolate the variable term, and then we're going to multiply or divide in order to solve for the variable. And then we should check our solution. Remember, to maintain equality, we must perform the same operation to both sides of the equation. Let's go and take a look at our first example. We have 0.3x minus 2.16 equals 9.9. Since the variable is on the left side of the equation, our goal is to manipulate the equation, so it's in the form of x equals some number. So in order to isolate the variable x, we need to undo this minus 2.16 as well as the multiplication involving the 0.3. And we always want to undo the addition or subtraction first. So the first step will be to add 2.16 to both sides of the equation. Here we need to be careful to line up the decimal point and the corresponding place values so we can add these decimals correctly. Now looking at the left side, minus 2.16 plus 2.16 would be 0, leaving us with 0.3x equals this sum here. Notice how the decimal point and the place values are lined up. Here we may want to add a 0 in the hundredths place value, and then we want to bring down the decimal point before we add. So 0 plus 6 would be 6, 9 plus 1 is 10, so we'll put a 0 here and carry a 1, 1 plus 9 plus 2 would be 12. So we have 0.3x equals 12.06. 0.3x means 0.3 times x. So to undo this multiplication, we'll have to divide both sides by 0.3. Well, 0.3 divided by 0.3 would be 1, and 1 times x would be x. And now we need to perform this division, so let's go ahead and set this up. We'll have 12.06 divided by 0.3. The first step is to make our divisor a whole number by moving the decimal point to the right one place to here, and then we must do the same to the dividend. So we'll move the decimal point from here to here, and then straight up into our quotient. And now we'll divide as we normally would. So we don't know how many 3s are in 12. Well, that would be 4. 4 times 3 would be 12. We subtract, this would be 0. Bring down the next digit, which is 0. Well, there are 0 3s in 0. 0 times 3 equals 0. Subtract, still 0. Bring down the last digit of 6. And now we need to ask how many 3s are in 6. Well, that would be 2. 2 times 3 is 6, with a remainder of 0. So x is equal to 40.2, or 40 and 2 tenths. If this solution is correct, it must satisfy the original equation, which means that 0.3 times 40.2 minus 2.16 must equal 9.9. Let's go ahead and check this on the calculator. So this does verify that our solution is correct. Let's go and take a look at a second example. Here we have x divided by 2.1 plus 4.93 equals 10.45. So again, our goal is to isolate the variable, so we want to manipulate the equation so it's in the form of x equals some number. The first step is to undo the addition of 4.93, so we'll subtract 4.93 on both sides of the equation. Again, making sure we line up the corresponding place values and the decimal point. So on the left side, plus 4.93 minus 4.93, that would be 0. So we have x divided by 2.1 equals this difference. So we'll bring the decimal point straight down and then subtract as we normally would. 5 minus 3 would be 2. Here we have to borrow. So we have 14 minus 9, that would be 5. And then 9 minus 4 is also 5. And now we need to undo this division to isolate the variable. Well, the opposite operation of dividing by 2.1 would be to multiply by 2.1. So I'll multiply both sides of the equation by 2.1. So on the left, 2.1 divided by 2.1 would simplify to 1 times x, or just x. And now we need to find this product here. Remember, because of the commutative property, we can change the order of this multiplication. So I'll write this as 5.52 times 2.1. And then notice how this has two decimal places and this has one. So our product must contain three decimal places. So now we'll go ahead and multiply as we normally would, and then put the decimal point in the correct position. So 1 times 2 is 2, 1 times 5, 1 times 5. Now I'll multiply by 2. 2 times 2 is 4. We'll put the 4 in the second column here. And then 2 times 5 is 10, carry a 1. 2 times 5 plus 1 would be 11. Now we'll add. We have 2, 9, 5, 1, 1. Now starting at the right, we'll move three places to the left and put our decimal point here so that we have three decimal places. So x is equal to 11.592, or 11 and 592 thousandths. If this solution is correct, if we replace x with this value, it should satisfy the original equation, which means 11.592 divided by 2.1 plus 4.93 must equal 10.45. Let's go ahead and check that. And once again, this verifies that our solution is correct. Okay, I hope you found this lesson helpful. Thank you for watching.